I have here with me the Mercedes-Benz EQC. This is an SUV. It corresponds to the GLC, but this is an all-electric car. And this will be the first all-electric premium SUV in the country. In fact, the first all-electric premium car in the country. And we are going to be driving it today on the tracks of the Indian Center for Automotive Testing at Manesar and on the streets around Delhi NCR. Well, the thing about this car is that although it's electric, it's got fantastic performance. That's what Mercedes-Benz promises. And that's because of the one motor that drives the front wheels, the other motor that drives the rear wheels. Mercedes says that the front drive motor is for economical driving, while the rear wheel drive motor adds, the motor that drives the rear wheels adds dynamic performance. And that's what we are also going to be testing around the streets in Delhi. On the inside, it's an all new generation vehicle with all the driver assist and the new infotainment system features available in it. So let's check it all out. The EQC shares its wheelbase with the GLC, but is slightly longer than its sibling and is just a little narrower and lower. And though both the cars share the same underpinnings, the resemblance to each other is just fleeting. And while there's the standard design of the EQC, the one that we are driving is the Edition 1886. This comes with Edition 86 badging on the front fenders, different 20-inch 10-spoke alloy wheels with EQ Blue lines, and the huge grille, which in the case of this special edition features black louvers that are surrounded by a black high gloss trim. At the center sits a huge three-pointed star, and the top of the black high gloss trim flows into the DRLs that surround the LED lamp cluster. But the best part of the car is its rear, with the LED tail lamps connected to each other with a light strip that is not just for show, but does light up in the dark as well. On the inside, the EQC is just like any other Mercedes. Well, the Mercedes SUVs, to be precise. There's the big screen in front of you, the MBUX system, the touchpad here, the steering wheel with all the touch controls is just like any other Mercedes SUV. Even the paddle shifters are there. But these paddle shifters are not for changing gears, but for changing the recuperation levels of the car. So yes, there are subtle differences, and even in the ambience, the AC aircon, the vents, they are different, very nice with the bronze inserts and burnishings. On the interiors, the twin material seats with 1886 badging on them, the golden beach stitching, and the general layout make it one of the classiest Mercedes cabins that I've seen in a long time. And of course, it is not the usual run-of-the-mill Mercedes interiors. And even though the interiors are superb, the space inside is not too great for the size of the vehicle. This is because the wheelbase is limited, because Mercedes has chosen to go with the same platform as the GLC. So that means that even the absence of an internal combustion engine in the front does not liberate more in-cabin space. And while the boot is large and long, the in-cabin space finally, like that of the GLC, is sufficient but not ample. With a lower roof height, the cabin also does not feel as roomy as that of the GLC. What it loses out in terms of spaciousness, it gains in terms of all the features, the systems that it is loaded with. The EQC is loaded with the latest of Mercedes assistance and infotainment systems, and also has the latest MBUX system up front, and it has the virtual assistant as well, which one can access by just saying, "Hey Mercedes." To drive the EQC is sports car quick. Throttle, or rather I should say pedal response, is electrifying. And the all-wheel drive system combined with the weight of the vehicle gives it the ability to utilize the huge amounts of torque that are being fed into these large 20-inch wheels. The cabin is super quiet, and even the motor whine that one can hear in most electric cars is missing from the EQC. The suspension setup is more towards comfort, and the ride quality was quite good for driving on our city roads, but the big problem was the ground clearance. While looking at the car, I thought it would be suspect, and while driving it, we did encounter lots of speed breakers that it could not negotiate with a simple crossing maneuver. The EQC's electrically assisted steering is quite responsive and direct, and in fact feels better than some of the Merc steering setups that feel overly assisted. The paddles on the side of the steering wheel are not for shifting gears, but for shifting levels of recuperation. There are three levels, and there's a zero recuperation setting as well, which basically means coasting. And then there's an auto mode for recuperation as well. All the test cycles spec the range of the vehicle on a single charge at over 400 kilometers. But on our drive around Delhi NCR, what we were seeing was a range of just over 350 kilometers. The onboard charger supports up to 7.5 kilowatt hour of AC charging, which can be made use of by putting a wall box that the company provides, but it can also handle up to 100 kilowatt of DC fast charging. Typically, the company claims that from a typical wall outlet, the car would take over 20 hours to charge fully from 10%. If charged through a company wall box, it can be charged in about 10 hours, while a 50 kilowatt hour DC fast charger can do it in about 90 minutes. With the EQC, there's finally an electric car for the rich people who want to make a statement and are environmentally conscious, but still want to stick to a premium brand. The EQC may not be the best packaged electric car out there, but it does meet all the requirements of a mid-sized luxury car that one may have. With a range of about 400 kilometers, range anxiety may very well also be a thing of the past. And while it ticks all the boxes in terms of an SUV and an electric car, except for maybe the ground clearance, there is a rather steep price to pay with the ex-showroom tag of 99.30 lakh rupees.